You're watching Tag TV. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Skyrim Zameka, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give you a glimpse of a country's diversity. One of the most popular and auspicious festivals in India, Ganesh Chaturthi, is a perfect mixture of culture, history and vibrancy. Celebrated in the honor of God of Wisdom, Lord Ganesh, it is a much-awaited occasion, especially in the southern and western parts of the country. Today, let's see how amid coronavirus, people in India welcome Ganesh this year with religious fervor and creative touch.
Huge idols of Lord Ganesha, crowded tents and chants of Ganpati Bappa Maurya reverberating in the air. All this marks the celebrations of the most resplendent festivals of Ganesh Chaturthi in India. Every year, people set up huge pandals, a temporary shed where they install a beautifully crafted idol of the elephant-headed god. This year too, a number of such structures ranging from COVID to other themes were set up across the country. In Ahmedabad city of Gujarat, a pandal showcased Ganesha portraying as a doctor wearing a white PPE kit along with a face mask and a stethoscope. The idol was seen rotating on a makeshift stage against murals of hospitals and quarantine centers painted on the backdrop.
इस साल हमने वो जो हमारे हम सबने एहसास किया कोरोना में कि भाई क्या-क्या तकलीफें पड़ी, क्या-क्या देखा हम लोगों ने, कैसे हम लोग इस माहौल में रहे, वो सब हम दिखाने के लिए सब दिखाया हुआ, लॉकडाउन दिखाया है, पीछे फिर लॉकडाउन ओपन हुआ, फिर जो वैक्सीन का किया सरकार ने, हम बस उनके सपोर्ट में रहके सब करना चाहते हैं।
Though this year grand celebrations could not take place amid coronavirus, but still people managed to keep the festive spirit alive with their creative ideas. While in Gujarat, Surat, a woman installed a 201 coconut-made Ganesh idol at a mall in the city, a chocolatier in Punjab's Ludhiana city carved out a beautiful eco-friendly Ganesha of more than 200 kgs of Belgian chocolate. Another creative as well as an informative initiative was taken by an environmental protection group in Bhubaneswar. They dressed the tree as Ganesha to integrate culture with environment and spread awareness about environmental issues and deforestation.
We don't want tree plantation to be just a mechanical event which people forget about it. You know, it is a relationship where you plant, nurture and you also protect the trees, and that is why as much as we can associate with cultural activities where it is part of our lives, and so we had been doing it.
In Pune, a devotee went a step ahead to mark his devotion for Lord Ganesha. Without disclosing his name, he offered a golden crown of 10 kilograms to Dagrushet Halwai Ganesha that has become a special attraction at the temple. Mumbai's Lal Bagh Charaja, that forms the major attraction on Ganesh Chaturthi every year, went virtual this time. As per the data, on the first day itself, over 34 lakh devotees took darshan of Lord Ganesha through online mode. Several other temples of the city too allowed a few devotees and asked the rest to do online darshan.
कोविड नियम को हम पूरा फॉलो कर रहे हैं, सबको बोला गया है कि मास्क लगा के ही यहाँ पे दर्शन के लिए आए और ज्यादा से ज्यादा घर बैठ के ही ऑनलाइन दर्शन कीजिए।
हिस्टोरिकल रिकॉर्ड सजेस्ट दैट गणेश चतुर्थी सेलिब्रेशंस were initiated by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj to promote culture and nationalism. However, it remained a family affair until freedom fighter Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak organized Ganesh Utsav in 1893. Every year, its festivities go on for 10 days, and on the last day, the idols are taken through the streets in a procession and immersed in a river or the sea. This immersion symbolizes the seeing off of Ganesha's journey towards his abode, taking away with him the misfortunes faced by mankind.
India is abode with a number of religions and ethnic groups that reside here in harmony. Recently, when the entire country was soaked in Ganesh Chaturthi festivities, examples of different religious communities celebrating and contributing to its celebrations were witnessed from different nook and corners of the country. Today, we will see two similar examples from Gujarat, where different religious communities contributed in Ganesh Chaturthi celebrations.
India has left the entire world spellblinded with its ability to be home to a number of different religions, cultures, and ethnicities. Recently, when the entire country was soaked in Ganesh Chaturthi festivities, people of different religious communities were seen contributing to its festivities in many ways. In Surat city of Gujarat, Muslim artists were preparing a thermocol Ganesh Pandal on the model of Ayodhya's Ram Temple.
इस वक्त है ना ये राम मंदिर का काम मिला है तो हम लोग ने राम मंदिर का काम स्टार्ट करा है हाँ तो ये इसके अंदर ऐसा है कि हम लोग कोई हिंदू मुस्लिम नहीं मानते हम लोग सब एक ही धर्म के तो हम लोग तो अगले वर्ष भी हम लोग ने सियासन के काम करे थे मंदिर के पीछे के बैकग्राउंड के
Led by Ansari, eight Muslim artisans worked for 10 nights straight to develop this beautiful thermocol replica of Ram Temple. Just like the Ram Temple in Ayodhya, the model has 174 pillars with four dome structures. This model will be placed at the Pandal in Surat's Arajan area and the workers hope that everyone likes and appreciates their hard work and noble gesture. In another city of Gujarat called Navsari, members of a Parsi family in Pinjara Mohalla have been celebrating the festival since the last 15 years as a gesture of the religious bond shared between the communities.
जी हमारे यहाँ पर हिंदू है पारसी है मुसलमान है और क्रिश्चियन भी है क्रिश्चियन भी बॉम्बे से आते हैं हर साल यहाँ पर मुस्लिम यहीं के और ज़्यादातर पारसी जो यहाँ से माइग्रेट करके एजुकेशन के लिए और जॉब के लिए जो बॉम्बे गए हुए थे वो हर साल गणपति आते हैं जब भी बाबा की सेवा स्थापना तब यहाँ पर चले आते हैं दस दिन के लिए
At least 35 members of the Khambata family from Navsari and Mumbai come together for installation of Ganesh idol and stay there till the idol is immersed in waters. The Ganesh idol is made of clay from the banks of River Ganges in Kashi and is adorned with American diamonds from Surat. Pinjara Mohalla has a sizable Parsi population of around 250 people and each year all the families of the area take part in this festival as a gesture of brotherhood and bonhomie. It is due to gestures and deeds like these that India stands united and undivided and this bond of brotherhood and bonhomie is clearly visible to the entire world.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A sculpture belonging roughly to the 7th and 8th century was found in India's northern Budgam district of the Jammu and Kashmir region. The sculpture recovered from Jhelum riverbed by a labourer while extracting sand was later brought to Srinagar city.
Identification yahi hai is object ki ye goddess Durga hai. ये मिनीचर ये है स्कल्पचर है तो गॉडेस दुर्गा जी जो है तो ये सीटेड ऑन लॉइन थ्रोन है ये ये काफ़ी रेयर ऑब्जेक्ट है। इसकी डेटिंग हमने उसी समय कहा क्योंकि ये आर्ट था पीक पे था 7th एंड 8th सेंचुरी में, उसके बाद में और एक पीक पे गया है, तो ये जो इसका पीरियड हमने का इसलिए 7th और 8th सदी में किया।
Carved on a black stone, the sculpture depicts two armed Hindu goddess Durga seated on a lion throne with lotus and chakra or wheel in one hand. The sculpture will be on display at Srinagar's Shri Pratap Singh Museum for the visitors. A nearly century-old film theatre, which is one of the last in the world to survive on cinema reels, in southern India's Madurai city is working hard to preserve its legacy. Established in 1939, the Central Theatre has been running movies using reels at a time when digital platform has taken over the world of cinema.
அதாவது இன்ன ரீல் ஓட்றதுக்கு நிறைய பேர் எங்களை நம்பி இருக்காங்க. அவங்களுக்காவது நாங்க ரீல் ஓட்ட வேண்டிய சூழ்நிலையில நாங்க இருக்கோம். ஏன்னா எத்தனை இன்னும் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டர்ஸ் வந்து இன்னும் வந்து பெட்டி வச்சு தான் ஓட்டிட்டு இருக்காங்க. கியூப் இப்போதான் மாறிட்டு வராங்க அவங்கலாம்.
The staff at the theatre is trained well to operate the reel machine, which has helped the theatre to keep the traditional method of movie watching alive and prevent it from shutting down. But with the changing times, the owners are also trying to shift to digital platform and screen movies both ways. The theatre, which has a seating capacity of 950 people, has priced its tickets at merely 40 rupees for men and 15 rupees for women. An architecture university in India's western Surat city has built an eco park that houses sculptures and furniture made out of non-biodegradable waste. What started as an entertaining learning activity for the students soon turned into an enthusiastic mission to save the environment. University students collected plastic bottles, caps, carry bags, wrappers, spoons among other things and turned them into beautiful sculptures. However, this was not the end of it. The students also created eco bricks, each of which accommodates 40 to 50 wrappers.
एक कोर आइडिया था कि जो प्लास्टिक वेस्ट हो रहा है, जो रिसाइकल नहीं हो सकता, उसको हम रिसाइकल करें। तो हमने उस प्रकार से अलग-अलग प्रोसेस की, डिजाइन प्रोसेस टू आर्किटेक्चर और इंटीरियर स्टूडेंट्स ने, जिसमें स्कल्पचर्स हैं, बैठने के लिए बेंचेस हैं, सर्पेंटाइन बेंचेस हैं, तो अलग-अलग टाइप के जो हम यूज़ कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि एक्टिविटीज़, गेम्स, चेस हो गया, तो हमने वो अलग-अलग टाइप का डिज़ाइन किया एंड देन हमने उसको एग्जीक्यूट किया।
Starting with 1,000 plastic bottles, students have now made a full-fledged eco-gallery with their efforts. Plastic takes centuries to decompose, making them a worrisome choice for the future products and their disposing. Therefore, coming up with such initiatives can really help in converting the trash into treasure.
India is a land where Sufism has not just flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of these myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at the Dargahs of Sufi saints. So today we take you to Dargah of Syed Nizamuddin Ahmed Gilani in Hyderabad city that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities.
An epicenter of faiths, a place where brotherhood and bonhomie between as many religions could be seen flourished and prospered at its best. The Dargah of Syed Nizamuddin Ahmed Gilani, situated in Hyderabad city of Telangana, is one such melange of diversities. Located on a hillock in the Jubilee Hills, the shrine witnesses a rush of devotees throughout the day. Whether one is Hindu, Muslim, Sikh or from any other community, the aroma of the shrine serenades them into cheerfulness and a belief of fulfillment ensues in them.
हकीम शाह बाबा के दरगाह के आसपीर क्या है, हिंदू बस्ती है, उनके पीछे भी हिंदू बस्ती है, ज़्यादातर हमारे लोगों से ज़्यादा हिंदू लोग यहाँ पर ज़्यादा फैज होके जाते, हमारे लोग ज़्यारत करने की वजह से आगे पीछे होते, मगर हिंदू लोग ज़्यादा ज़्यारत करते और यहाँ से फैज होके जाते यहाँ पर।
It's been said that Syed Nizamuddin Ahmed Gilani came to the Deccan in 1635 AD. he was invited by the Qutub Shahi rulers. Also known as Hakim Baba, the saint was a practitioner of Yunani medicine and gained popularity after treating Abdullah Qutub Shah, a Golconda ruler who was suffering from some serious illness. It has been 400 years since his death, but to this day devotees have immense belief in him and visit his darga to pray for healing.
Muhammad Qutub Qutub Shah ke ilaaj ke liye bulaye the inko. इनके हाथ पे उनका इलाज हुआ सो है, उन्होंने ठीक होने के बाद हजरत को यहीं पे मुकाम करने की इजाज़त दिए थे। हजरत उनके फौज के कई सारे लोगों का इलाज करे और उन्होंने यहाँ पर खिदमत करते हुए यहीं पे पर्दा फरमाए। मानसो बातेदार, मैं भी यहाँ पर 5-6 साल से आता हूँ। यहाँ फजा बहुत काफ़ी सारा जुमेरा जुम्मा काफ़ी सारी पब्लिक रहती इधर, और हकीम शाह बाबा एक हकीम थे, इलाज के लिए आए थे। मोहम्मद कुलीब कुतुब शाह के इलाज के लिए आए थे हम।
द दरगाह ऑफ हकीम बाबा इज अ परफेक्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ कम्युनल हार्मनी दैट इज विटनेस्ड थ्रू आउट द लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ ऑफ आवर कंट्री। द सॉलिडैरिटी अमंग द डिफरेंट रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज हैज रिमेन्ड अ हॉलमार्क ऑफ इंडियाज यूनिटी सिंस टाइम इमेमोरियल।
And now we will move to Baramulla district of Jammu and Kashmir, where a cycling rally for women was organized, where women from all over the country participated. Take a look.
Empowerment is not about rising above anyone. It is always about exploring one's own potential and being a better version of self. Different individuals and organizations all over the world keep on taking a number of steps to work for the empowerment of women. A similar step was taken by the Indian Army in Baramulla district of Jammu and Kashmir, where a women-only cycle rally was organized to promote cycling and fitness activities among women.
Wonderful ride. I am representing WDR, the team from Jammu. So glad to be in Kashmir riding after such a long time. Never thought this could happen. All thanks to the Indian Army for organizing this. We look forward to more rides in Kashmir. And wonderful ride, beautiful views, and very well organized.
Named Ride Kashmir, the rally started for Baramulla district and terminated at the line of control near Kaman Aman Setu, Uri. Around 140 women from all across the country paddled across lush green roadways and serene hills to cover a distance of 65 kilometers. The rally was flagged off by the actor, model and sports enthusiast Milind Soman along with his wife Ankita Kamar.
बहुत अच्छा रहा आज का cycling ride Baramulla से यहाँ तक। ये है command post और शायद 65 किलोमीटर का अंतर था। द वेदर वॉज फैंटास्टिक, बहुत ही अच्छा लगा, अरेंजमेंट्स बहुत अच्छे थे और खूबसूरती, जगह की खूबसूरती तो मतलब कुछ बोल ही नहीं सकते कि इतनी खूबसूरत है।
द आइडिया ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग अ वुमेन्स एक्सक्लूसिव रैली वॉज कंसीव्ड आफ्टर एन ओपन साइकिल रैली विच वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज ऑन 13th of August दिस ईयर।
एक ओपन साइकिल रैली हुई थी जिसके अंदर सभी यूथ ने हिस्सा लिया था बारामूला से कमान पोस्ट के लिए। उस टाइम पे बारामूला के बच्चों का, जो लड़कियां थीं, उनकी एक रिक्वेस्ट आई कि ये ओपन मत करिए, एक हमारे लिए सिर्फ ओनली वुमन इवेंट कीजिए। तो हमने उसके बारे में सोचा, हमने सोचा कि इससे पहले कि बर्फ़ पड़ जाए हम जल्दी से जल्दी इस इवेंट को कर सकें। मगर एक महीने के अंदर जब हमने ये रीच आउट करा तो इतने लोगों का रिक्वेस्ट आया पूरे देश भर में से कि हम लोग इस चीज़ के अंदर, हमारे पास कैपेसिटी नहीं थी इसको मैनेज करने के लिए।
पार्टिसिपेंट्स वर फेलिसिटेटेड एट द एंड ऑफ द मैराथन बाय सर्टिफिकेट्स एंड कैश प्राइजेस। द इंडियन आर्मी कीप्स ऑन ऑर्गेनाइजिंग अ नंबर ऑफ इवेंट्स टू वर्क टूवर्ड्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एम्पावरिंग वुमेन थ्रू डिफरेंट स्पोर्ट्स एंड गेम्स।
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section, World in Focus.
A bamboo forest called Chikuri no Michi in the Arashiyama district of Kyoto is one of the most iconic sceneries in Japan. It attracts thousands of tourists every year. Pictures of this bamboo forest are certain to be found on any website or tourist pamphlet for Kyoto, because the beauty of this place captures the hearts of tourists. Many tourists donning traditional Japanese outfits visit the place to get a unique experience. The forest of giant bamboo extends more than a kilometer. The fence on the site is also made of bamboo. Many of the bamboos here reach up to 25 meters and with a diameter up to 25 centimeters. Visitors can hire rickshaw called Jinrikisha in Japanese to enjoy guided tours through the narrow path in the bamboo forest. And in the middle of the forest, there is Nonomiya Shrine, a small beautiful Shinto shrine where imperial princesses used to spend time to pray in old times.
Corona wattara kono Nihon naradewa no take のいっぱいあるところですごい京都らしいところだからなんかその一番日本を感じたいなって思ってる人に来てほしいなって思います。
There are many different entrances into the bamboo forest, including from nearby Tenryuji Temple. Also, the sign pointing to the forest can be seen along the main road of the tourist area of Arashiyama.The forest is open 24 hours a day and there is no entry fee. It takes only 15 minutes train ride from Kyoto station, so no one should miss visiting this magical place. Hundreds of paddle board enthusiasts recently brightened the waters of Moscow's Roaring Canal with a flashy masquerade to enjoy the last warm days of this autumn.The participants had a chance to show off their costumes as well as to take part in a friendly race. While some came to choose their costume based on looks or fun, others made a statement with their choice.
Мы бегуны. Мы любим бегать, потому что бег – это жизнь, это спорт. Но в связи с тем, что московский марафон вчера отменили, Мы хотим поддержать организаторов московского марафона и показать, что мы за то, чтобы проводили московский марафон. Это наши футболки со всех марафонов, которые мы бегали. И, так сказать, мы бегали, бегаем и будем бегать.
Paddleboarding became increasingly popular in central Russia over recent years, although there are no seas nearby. Enthusiasts sail on many lakes, rivers and the city's water ponds.Japan is a leading country with strong environmental protection policy. The government promises zero carbon emission by 2050. To achieve this, many companies and sectors are encouraged to step up their effort to use environment-friendly materials, including construction. One of such promising materials is a volcanic rock that is found in abundance in Japan, and the country's volcanically active land. Even its natural symbol, Mount Fuji, is actually a volcano.This company in Tokyo is promoting the use of volcanic rock to cover surface of building walls, bridges and roadside. The idea aimed at the beginning to make cosmetic effect to make building blending more in the surrounding natural scenery. But later, moss and plant were growing out of the porous surface of the volcanic rock. This unexpected development revealed the potentiality of volcanic rock for fostering vegetation.
富士吉田は富士山が綺麗と同時に溶岩がたくさんあったんですね。で、庭に溶岩がたくさんあって、庭の溶岩に植物がついてるってことが一番よく子供の時からしてたんで。で、多孔質じゃなきゃ溶岩であっても意味がないなっていう。多孔質な環境のある溶岩、その穴には生き物や昆虫や緑化もできる穴がたくさん開いてると。その石を特徴としさせて、アイデアとしていろんな形の商品を考えてきてるんですね。
Natural volcanic rock can be used in different sizes and shapes, even cut into a thin board of concrete,
with embedded volcanic rock that can be attached to the exterior of an already existing surface. Another material which does not contain concrete is super thin, ultra-lightweight material which can be cut to any size and attached even to a curved surface of different shapes. The environment-friendly feature of volcanic rock makes it suitable to revive the ecosystem of the urban areas when used as a construction material.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Karim Zimek, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.